What's up, everyone, and once again, welcome back to Luigi's Mansion, Dark Moon. Last time, we started up our fourth mansion. Well, it's not really a mansion, but you know what I mean. The Secret Mine, and we did D1 Cold Case, and in this episode, we're gonna be starting up D2 Hit Rock Bottom. I hope you all understood my reference at the end of the last episode. According to the Toad Assistant, ghosts, booze especially, have been very active in the mine. Perhaps the security camera photo will tell us what they're up to. Hey, youngster. I finished processing the security camera image. Shall we take a look? Yowzer! What's all this? Look at those ghosts stuck in those crystals. Did the booze put them there? Why?
Alright, let's take a look around. Oh, look who's back.
They've been dragging that painting all over Evershade Valley. Whoever's behind all this really cares about that painting.
We definitely didn't see who it is in the last episode.
In his last report, the Toad said something about the crystals having strengthening qualities.
Hi, Booze. Look at this guy in the bottom.
It's just like the Toad said. The Booze are running amok.
Look at this guy pushing a minecart.
That shadow. Does it look familiar to you? Nah, I'm just imagining things.
I don't know, Egad. Look at this guy. There's always one Boo just staring into the camera with his mouth open.
They seem to be extracting crystals from that quarry. Why would they need crystals? I don't like this at all.
Alright, I believe that's all we can look at. I think. Let's take one final look around. What is this? Money? That's a thing of money right there.
Luigi, I didn't like at all what we saw in there. Why are those Boos putting ghosts inside crystals? And who is commanding them? That sinister laughter coming from the bottom of the mine. Do you think it came from their leader? That photo was taken just before you arrived, so they're probably still down there.
I didn't hear this sinister laughter, but maybe you guys did.
But the only way to know for sure is to investigate the crystal quarry.
Look at that map go.
You'll find my E-gates on the way there. Don't be afraid to use them. Okay, Sonny. Get to the bottom of the mine and stop those Boos from doing whatever it is they're doing.
So, right off the bat, like literally behind our starting point, is the Boo.
I'm Booger. Why must you always pick on me?
That is a terrible pun. Hi, guy. Fuzzball dude. I'll play with you in a second. I gotta get this Boo really quick. I don't think the fuzzballs can actually do anything to you, which is kind of a nice thing, I guess. Like, they can't actually hurt you, but they can get in your way, certainly. I can't even see where I am. There we go, give me your tongue. Through the lift thing. Oh, I thought he could get caught in the elevator just for a second there. All right, and suck up the Boo and almost the fuzzball. Will you get off of me? Bye. All right, so let us see here. I believe, is it in this mission? I thought we could go upstairs, but I don't think we can. We actually want to go this way first. We're just really quick. If I'm thinking of the right area. I don't think I'm thinking of the right area. Hold on. Give me 2 seconds to check. There's some stuff we got to get, and I don't remember if it's here or not. I don't think it's here. I think it's in a different area. Ignore me. Or is it here? I'm so confused. I know that there's a place where we gotta go outside, and this is the only place we can really go outside. You know what? If we miss said thing, we'll come back, because it was a few days ago when I wrote down these notes, so I don't especially remember, but we'll come back if we miss said thing. All right, let's head down the elevator. We are back in the airway. Alright. Let's see, is there anything we can still get around here? Is this gonna give us any money? Oh no, that was that thing. Never mind. We don't need that. We're just gonna make our way over here because of course now we don't have Toad. So we can go across here and go through the door, and that was a gold crow that I am now gonna miss out on. We are now at the crossroads. Oh wait, I remember this. So, this thing. This is an E-gate.
Hello, it's me.
Alright, so as you can see, this is the E-gates. I'm gonna head on in here and, well, it's a teleporter. Long story short, it is a teleporter. Go ahead and pick this key up and head back through. Actually, let's just go through and then we can melt that. And it's gonna give us our key. Now, really quick, I'm gonna pause just before we continue. And I'm gonna find out if we are, in fact, missing something here. Give me 2 seconds. Yeah, I'm dumb. I knew that there was something. There is another place we can go outside. I'll meet you there. Remember the other place we've been outside so far? The front door? I'm so dumb. Anyway, so if we head out to the chalet approach, I just picked up a chicken. Let's get rid of the chicken really quick. We want to flash this, and it should come back. There we go. So that sets the chicken on fire. Of course it does. And if we bring it over here, and back down this way, there is now a new painting. And this is, of course, a gem. I believe you can get this on most later missions. Well, I'm not actually sure on that, but just get it now and it's out of the way. I'll meet you back downstairs. So, I just remembered there's also another gem that we can get. Well, I say I remembered, I read my notes. If we go back to the right, is this the right area? I believe I'm in the right place here. We need to go back to the Prospector's Crossing. Come on, Luigi, you got this, buddy. Is that through here? Yes, it is. So there is a gem frozen in the ice. How do we get said gem? Well, I believe... Well, there's a gold spider right there. We can grab that. Because why not? I don't think we're going to be getting the triple star ranking here, which is unfortunate, but I screwed up in the beginning, so what can I say? Where is it? There was something around here. Oh, you know what? I think I just remembered. Yeah, we can dark light that. Go ahead and suck those up, and then I believe if we spin this... Yeah, that brings out the wall and gives us some logs, which makes it enough. Well, if we put that one on there, spinning around on top of the gem, apparently. Put that log on there, and put this log on there, and then go on there ourselves. It is enough to break the ice. So we can go ahead and grab our next gem. Okay, now I'll meet you back where we were. I can almost guarantee we're not getting a triple star ranking in this mission. I'm just gonna throw that out there. Anyways, moving right along through this next door. I've wasted so much time. I've been recording like 10 minutes already. Heading through this next door. We are at the skip slope. This exceedingly long portion of the map that we saw. Let's go, Luigi. Yeah, let's slide. Okay, so, there's gonna be one gem on this slide and a key that we gotta grab too. There we go, grab that one. And then I believe if we go this way, I failed it. Oh, we're gonna have to do that again. There's a gem if you manage to make it through there. It's timing based, so yeah. You gotta basically get that perfect. And I'll be showing that off in just a second. So let's activate this E-gate. If we go through this one, it takes us back up to the top. So let's just give this another try. Now, the timing, to get the timing right, you need to slide into the right-hand side just so that you slow down a bit here. And never mind, I screwed that up. You gotta go over to the left there. You saw that opening? Yeah, that is where we've got to get to. And in order to get the timing right, I believe that you need to go to the right. First, let's just see what this is really quick, actually. A bucket. Okay. It's moving. Okay, bye, Bucket. I'm gonna try that again. We can see down there. I think it was, in fact, a greenie. We can kind of see him. We hold back at all? Does that work? We just slam into the wall? Oh, no, I should have just sped for it. Oh, we did it. And we got the gem. Sweet. Okay, was not expecting to make that. Now, where'd the greenie go? Where'd the greenie go? Also, the little icon didn't show up. That was odd. Greenie? There was a greenie under that bucket, right? I'm very confused as to where that bucket is now. Can I pull that out again? Oh, wait! Don't tell me it was a gold greenie. That would suck if that was a gold greenie. Either way, I don't think it was. I think it was just a regular greenie. But I'm curious where that bucket freaking went to. Unless I'm just not seeing it. Anyway, we are now in the smuggler's hideout. We can suck that off and get some money. I'll take it. There's also some money up top as well. Hello there. Alright, so let's take this and melt the ice on this guy and then get out of the way. Oh, I didn't do it. Come on. Melt the ice on this guy. And he stabs his friend. And then gold bats come out, apparently. I don't know if that's what triggered that, but we got some money, so I'll take it. Alright, let's go ahead and melt the ice in the back here. And that is a sneaker! Of course it is! Damn it. That greenie was a little, he got a bit of a headache right there. I'm sorry, dude. I know the pain of headaches all too well. In fact, I went to bed last night with a freaking headache, so, yeah. Alright, let's go ahead and do that. And one more, there we go. And now I believe... Oh, we're gonna have to grab our log again. Set it on fire again. And once we put out- Oh, melt this ice- Not put out this ice. Wait, no, crap. Not once we do that. We use the exhaust function on the vacuum cleaner to close the window. And then we can melt this. That's what I meant. Come on, last bit. There you go. Now let's just do one final check around here. I don't believe there's anything else we can check. I don't know if- having that guy kill his friend. Actually, wait, there's a chest right here. I don't know if stabbing that guy does anything other than the gold bats. I'm guessing that's what caused them to appear. Okay. Chest? You have a whole 5 coins for us. Alright then, moving right along. Into the shaft. So, by spinning this, with the exhaust function actually, we can slide down. Now, as we're doing this, there's gonna be things happening. There's gonna be coins to get. And, there's gonna be a couple other things. You can see there's a greenie out there with one of those crystals and some slammers. Looks like that's a little heavy. Oh, he's gonna drop it, dude. Help him out. There you go. Let's keep going. See what else we can find. Gold greenie! Give me yourself! There we go. And I believe... Was it that guy? Maybe it wasn't that guy. I thought that there was a gem down here, but maybe not. I thought that he was holding an actual gem, but that's not an actual gem. You can get the gold greenie. Anyway, now, you see that door right there that we can't seem to do anything with right now? Well, we still can't do anything with it. Just go down. Well, actually, there's some coins right there that I'll go ahead and grab. And bats! Bats, 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 bats! Okay, they're gone. Let's just keep on going down. And right here, there's a little chain we can pull on, and then if we rise back up, that will have opened the door and revealed to us our next sapphire, which I will gladly accept. Wowie! We got 4 in this episode. Got 4 in the last, 5 in the last episode, and 4 in this episode. We are not doing bad. Actually, I say that we're actually going to be getting another gem in this episode, so it's going to be 5 for 5. Neat. Hmm. Luigi, it is a good job that didn't fling you any, like, a slight amount further. So, you may be wondering how you're supposed to get through here. This looks like a dead end, right? This is a mirror. Well, it's the ice that makes it look like a mirror. If you had the 3D on, which I'm going to turn on right now, you can actually tell that it's a mirror. If you have the 3D off, like I did, and like you guys are seeing it, you can't tell that it's a mirror. So, well, unless you, like, shine your light out there and you can kind of see the reflection, but still. It's a neat little puzzle right there. And it looks like that is all we can do in here. So let's move on. That's the Coward's Chasm, by the way. Alright, the Deep Hall. And a phone call. It's been a little while. I'll happily talk to Professor Egad.
Are you there? I can hear you. Probably made it to the bottom mine. So far, so good. Crystal Quarry should be nearby. Try to find a way in. But what if you do? Don't put with...
Ciao. I don't know what he says there. If anyone actually knows what he's supposed to say there, please let me know, because I don't. Also, there is a gem up there that you can see that we are going to have to get. Let's go ahead and boil the kettle. Actually, what does boiling the kettle do? That gives us hearts. I'll take the hearts. Thank you. Let's see here. I believe we can actually go outside. Yes, we can. Into the pit mine. Let's blow on this. Now, what do we have in here? I believe this is actually where we're supposed to go, but still. We got our gold bone. I'll accept that. Why wouldn't I accept that? And we pull on this rope. It's gonna start the conveyor belt moving. We got some freaking beetles to deal with. I swear, if you are the things that give me damage after all this time. Alright, and then if we go over here and spin this around, this is gonna give us some blocks of coal. And where does the conveyor belt leave? Why, into an E-gate. And whoa, it was you. Of course it was. Where have we just seen an E-gate? Well, I didn't actually point it out, but right there in the room we were just in. So that is how we get coal inside, because Luigi doesn't know how to use his hands. Anyway, also the exhaust function on the poltergeist gets a lot of use in this mission. Just gonna point that out there. All right, so let's grab this. Go ahead and put that on fire, and then I believe we can fire up at our final gem. Not if you miss, Luigi. All right, then. Try that again. Right there. Boom. And that's gonna give us our fifth sapphire of the mission. Sweet. Now, you may have been wondering what is in this big red gaping hole over here. Don't worry, we are gonna take a look right now. Looks like that's where that picture was taken. And also, that's really kind of a terrifying image right there. Like, the boos are holding the other ghosts hostage like that. It's kind of terrifying in a way. Anyway, get rid of that. Pull on this thing. And it's gonna open up this room. This is the cinder mine. Because of course we need our key to open that place up. What happens if we turn this on? Don't you get me, mouse. Don't you do it. Your freaking bug friends did the same thing. Alright, we've got a log over here too. You better get out of my way, dude. And your friend over there. I see you. I will melt you if you come near me. Melt that too. Alright, anything in these? I'm imagining a key, maybe. No key. Oh wait, never mind. The key is on the ceiling. The key is on the ceiling, like that. Give me yourself, mouse. Oh, the gold mouse, gold mouse, gold mouse! Oh, we also got the gold, oh, we like flashed it right at the last second before we collected the key, so we got the gold bar too. Oh, it looks like this room is haunted. Give me that thing. That looks like it's kind of expensive. Actually, never mind, these things have no monetary value, probably, because none of the other gems in the freaking Evershade Valley do. All right, let's open up the door. And crash this freaking party. Huh. I'm excited. So, you've already met Strong Sneaker, meet Strong Slammer, and Strong Greenie. They all disappeared. Where'd they go? Did they break out? Oh, I guess we gotta check it. Oh, yeah, they broke out, all right. Hi! Or he's about to. So you check each one, and that is going to give you the option to... Oh, there we go. Now he broke out. You check each one, and that is going to give you the option to actually flash them. You can actually open them all up at the same time, I think, if you want to try get all three at once. But I don't really want to try that. I mean, we could probably do it, but I'm just going to open them up. Well, then. Never mind. They opened it up themselves. Oh, God. Please just get the greenie so I can get the slammer out of the way. There we go. Slammer, you got 150 HP. Get over here. I'm just going to do the single. Why not? Please don't break off. Give me yourself. And one, two, three. Oh, damn it. I had a little bit too much HP right there. But there we go. Hey, look, an E-gate. Aw, oh, looks like we're not going to use that. Incoming call.
Hello?
Grimey, what was that going on down there? Those boos fled scene of the... Hey? And you say they're ordering to take the crystals away? Well, bright side, you managed to cap those powerful ghosts. I'll need to see them. I'm bringing you back.
Ciao.
That voice is getting worse every time I do it. You know, what is it? Words. The broken connection voice. Alright, but... I'm not feeling too confident. That's a double star. We took a little bit too long there. Oh well, this is not a single star.
Good to see you back here, Luigi. Let's see what you've got.
We have a couple new ghosts for you, Egad. Well, we got some gems, too. There's 1 gem, 2 gem, 3 gem, 4 gem, and 5 gem. We have our strong slammer, and our strong greenie, and our boo. I like how the boo just laughs. He's like he knows he's been caught, but he's still gonna laugh about it. And there we go. Even though we caught the greenie first, it showed the slammer first. Oh well.
I've got a theory. That strong ghost you captured back in the old clockworks. I think I know what happened to him. Someone seems to be controlling all the ghosts in the valley, but it doesn't stop there. They've also figured out a way to use the mind crystals to strengthen the ghosts. And if they've been extracting crystals this entire time and taking them elsewhere, I fear we may be up against much stronger ghosts in the future. That wouldn't be good. On top of things, we still have no idea who's pulling the strings behind all this.
Oh, don't we?
Who could orchestrate such a thing? Luigi, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I don't know, and I guess we won't know until the next episode, because that is the end of that mission. And we've opened up D3 Across the Chasm. That is, of course, going to be in the next episode. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.